We were about nine. So we're going to me nana's and she was having everyone round, big two and all that. And every family, you know, member of family used to go, didn't they all stay together New Year's Eve and all have a berry, they fucking all end up boxing in the end, but they all used to get together, yeah. Didn't they? So me ma went, yeah, this kid, I said, can I stay up and listen to the bells? Remember, you just made that's up, right? You're giving it all your Lang Syne gear, yeah. Weren't you? So she went, all right, well, we were all down to me ma's. She said, about 11:30. I said, okay. So me and my mate, he's staying over, he's sleeping over, and we were walking with me ma, and we're going to me nana's. And next minute, Blemmon Street runs up to the top of Scotty. It's a dead steep. It starts at the castle, the pub on the corner. It runs right up, and it's a dead steep hill. So as we come, my ma's had a few ales and that. And as we're coming, here's this looked like a woman with white hair in a wheelchair, and she's struggling to get up the fucking hill. And my ma goes, all right, lads, go and give her a push. You and him, grab the wheelchair. Fucking terrible, lad. Who's left her out there? She said, she's pushing away up Blenheim Street. Go and push her to where she's going. It's about 11:30 at night. We're about 9. I said, all right. So I goes, and it's a fella, but he had like dead long hair. You know, like fucking, it was like Jesus. Go down to there. So we both grabbed. I said, where are you going, mate? And he went, the block's up the top. The block's up the top. By Betty's, the block's up the top. I said, oh, all right. So we pushes him, and he's fucking pissed himself. So he's sloshing in the pisses, you know, as he's going up. So we get to this, like it's like a derelict block. Couple of bondies on it. And then a couple of normal outers, right? So she goes, I live on the second floor. So he says, all right, mate, I'll go. Who shall I go? He went, go and tell her to get the lads to tell the lads to come down and get me up. So I said, all right. So he runs up. My mate stays with him, and he stunk. Never smelt anything like it. Just pissed up to death. And don't think, you know, he just used to piss himself in the wheelchair. So he goes up. So I knocks on the door. This album, you know, with the whiff of the house come out, you know, fucking air stood up with the whiff. And I'm fucking hell. She come out saying, what's up? I said, it's your husband. We've got him downstairs. And he said, will you get the lads to get him up? She must have had a couple of sons. She went, there's no fucking lads in here. He went, is he drunk? I said, yeah, he's had a few drinks. Like I said, you know, I said, yeah, he's drunk. She went, well, fucking leave him there. And it was when winters got really cold. It was freezing. So we goes down. I said to him, you know, we're only kids that had, you know, our man and our woman, you respected your elders then, didn't you? So she went, fuck him. And she just slammed the door. So I went out. And I said, hey, mate. I said, your wife said the lads are not here and to leave you there. He went, hey, you, him, get me up these fucking stairs. Me and my mate Stephen, we're fucking shitting ourselves. So I went.
This is in the house?
No, this is outside the block.
Frank. Outside the block,
outside
yeah.
The block. He lived on the second landing.
Okay.
So I said, come on, let's fucking get him up. So we were fucking frightened of him anyway. He was like a little fucking, like a little gremlin thing in the, with white long hair, fucking swiveling in the piss.
Weird.
So as we grabs Graz a handle and we're bumping him up and he's sloshing away in the piss and we're bumping him up. Anyway, mate, we hit him to the top and we couldn't fucking lift him. We were only nine, the last step. And he went, fuck off. And he flew out the wheelchair.
Fucking
and
hell.
He went down every fucking stair, right? And he was just lying there on the floor. And his head was, he had this like big long white wig and it was just fucking full of blood.
Oh
and
my
I went,
God.
Fucking hell, we've killed him. We killed him. You know, we're looking at him. And it was just, it was like casualty. It was just trails of blood. It was on the floor like that. You know what I mean? So he runs down, me and him, and I'm going, mate. And he was just out, and he was all fucking blood. I said, we've killed him. I'm screaming. My mate couldn't talk. He was just jumping up and down, going, no time to scream, but nothing was coming
just
out.
Gone, like, gone.
Just
yeah.
Gone. So I said, fuck this. So I rang round to the do where they were all having to do, and I ran in. They were all rotten. And I said, I was like the song Queen. Mum would have just killed a man. I said, now, mother, I've killed a fella. I said, I've killed a fella. And he went,
oh my God.
What fella? They were all pissed. I said, at the fella in the wheelchair, but that was a woman. Have you killed her? I said, it's not a woman. I said to mum, it's a man. We've killed him. I'm sobbing. My uncle's like, lad, calm down. But they're all laughing, right? Because they're all fucking rotten. I said, he had no legs. I said, he slipped out the wheelchair and he's gone down every fucking stair. So they're all just buzzing. So anyway, me ma grabs the phone. House phone's down. She went, shall I tell 999? Said he. So he goes, yeah, go ahead. We'll go round now and see where he is. So me ma dials 999. She gets on the phone. She went, hello, mate. Can you send an ambulance round? She said, to Blemmon Street. There's a fellow with no legs. It's New Year's Eve. He's fell down every stair and the kids think they've killed him. She went, is this a fucking joke? You know what I mean? And then my dad had ran down with my uncle and he'd found him. He was in a bad way. And my mate was just still standing there, jumping up and down, not saying that, you know, in shock. Yeah. And anyway, they got him up. He was all right. The ambulance came and it took him away. But I always remember fucking, you know, it was time for the bells to come. My mum said, come on, yeah, the bells are coming. I said, I'll just go to bed, man. I said, I don't want to stay up no more.